When I first saw this on the shelf at the thrift store, I thought it was just an old and oddly shaped USB flash drive. But then I noticed where it says portable USB hard drive. It's a MicroGem QuickiDrive sold at CompUSA in October 2006 for $39.99. It's 2 gigabytes, and it says no more floppies or bulky disks. Store and transfer files, music, photos, videos, and graphics anywhere you go. Travel tough, rubberized coating, touch me. And they give you a little hole to touch it. And yes, like most rubberized coatings from this age, it has gone sticky. So here you can see the size comparison between a typical USB flash drive, commonly known as a thumb drive because it's approximately the size of your thumb, and this USB hard drive. But it's still a lot smaller than the USB hard drives you're probably familiar with. This is a common 2.5-inch USB hard drive. That's because whereas this has a 2.5-inch laptop-style hard drive in it, this one has a 1-inch MicroDrive in it. MicroDrives were invented in 1999 by IBM and Hitachi. They are a 1-inch mechanical spinning hard drive that uses the same interface as CompactFlash cards. And actually, CompactFlash cards came out first a couple years earlier, but they were very expensive and they had very limited storage capacity. So the solution at the time was to make a smaller hard drive that would fit in almost the same size as a compact flash card. They were just a little bit thicker, but most devices that can accept a compact flash card can also accept a micro drive. Micro drives were most popularly used in the early to mid 2000s in digital cameras, camcorders, portable MP3 players, and pocket PCs. And for a price comparison, in 2003, a 4 gigabyte micro drive cost $500, and a 4 gigabyte compact flash card cost $1,500, so a microdrive was obviously much cheaper. But by 2006, the prices of flash memory had dropped rapidly. I saw one report of someone who bought a 4 gigabyte compact flash card in September 2006 for $59 after a rebate. So to get a 2 gigabyte microdrive for $39, you're not really doing that much better on price. So this must have been the last gasp of these micro drives to try to sell them as USB hard drives. And in addition to the 2 gigabyte version here, I've also seen these quickie drives in 4, 5, and 6 gigabyte capacities. These micro drive based quickie drives may be the smallest USB hard drives ever made. There were smaller hard drives than these micro drives. Toshiba introduced a 0.85 inch hard drive, and there's one Japanese company called Elecom which at least announced that they were going to sell USB hard drives with those 0.85 inch drives in them. But aside from their Japanese website and a couple press releases at the time, I can't find any evidence of them actually reaching market, at least outside of Japan. So I'm pretty sure, at least in North America, these were the smallest USB hard drives ever made. And I also noticed there's something rattling around inside this. That's because it comes with a cable, as it mentions on the back. So in case you don't want to have this big thing hanging off your computer's USB port, you can attach it to the included USB extension cable. So I'm going to open this up, see if it works, and just so we have a fair comparison, I have a 2 gigabyte compact flash card. Now this is a lot newer than 2006, but it's some no-name brand, so I'm not expecting it to be one of the really high performance versions of these. Inside the package we get the QuickiDrive, whose rubberized coating has definitely gone very sticky with age. So I've wrapped some electrical tape around it so I can at least handle it without getting my fingers all sticky. We also get the USB extension cable, which is surprisingly thick and well shielded. Also a quick installation guide for PC, Mac, and Linux. And if you want an example of why Linux didn't really catch on, here's instructions for Windows and Mac, and they basically just say plug it in and it should work. But in the Linux instructions, it tells you to execute this very long and complicated terminal command, and then check the device information in hwconf, write down the mount point, make a directory in /mnt, for example mkdir /mnt/usbhd, then execute mount /dev/sda1/mnt/usbhd if mount point was .dev/sda. Yeah, that's why 2006 didn't turn out to be the year of Linux on the desktop after all. That sticky, rubberized coating was unacceptable, so I tried cleaning it with some alcohol wipes, and that actually worked. It got rid of all the stickiness. Now it doesn't look that great. You can see a splotchy appearance, but that's a lot better than having it be all sticky when you try to touch it. Obviously, a spinning mechanical hard drive in there is going to generate heat, so they give it a little sort of transformer-style cooling vent on it. And that looks like an access indicator LED. And this is the cap for the USB connector, which is rather firmly attached, but there it is. And here's a computer from 2006 that I'm going to test it with, my ThinkPad T61. But the problem is, these are the only two USB ports on the machine. They're both vertical and right next to each other, so that means I'll need to use this USB extension cable that came with the QuickiDrive. And I'm going to hold the QuickiDrive right up to the camcorder when I plug it in, so maybe you can hear it spin up. Well, I could hear it seeking the heads, but I couldn't really hear the spindle motor. And from this normal distance that I have it in front of me here, I can't hear anything. So these micro drives are nice and quiet. And the computer recognized the drive, and it came pre-formatted to FAT32. And the actual capacity, if you were going to measure it in decibel gigabytes, is 2.14 gigabytes. Now I'm going to use H2TestW to verify the drive and to check how fast it is. So this is the test of the micro drive, and I'll come back when it's done and see the results. Here it is writing the data, and maybe you can just barely hear it. The test of the micro drive is complete, and it finished without errors. You can see the writing and verifying speeds: 3.47 megabytes per second writing and 4.62 megabytes per second verifying or reading, which is within the advertised range for these micro drives. They're supposed to give you between 4 and 6 megabytes per second. And after being on for about 20 minutes, the micro drive is warm to the touch, but it's not hot. Now I'll plug in the compact flash card and its reader. And there's the compact flash card. You can see it shows up as 1.84 gigabytes according to Windows. Or if you're going to measure it in decimal gigabytes, it's 1.986 gigabytes. Now I'm going to run the test on the compact flash card, and I'll come back when that's done. The test of the compact flash card is done, and you can see the write speed is actually not that much faster than the micro drive. It's about the same as the reading speed of the micro drive, but the verify or reading speed of the compact flash card is a lot faster. But this is not a vintage compact flash card from 2006 that I'm comparing it to. It's some modern cheapo brand card, which is still probably a lot faster than the cards that were available back then. There's the QuickiDrive popped apart, which was a lot easier than I expected. All it took was a little bit of prying and it just snapped apart. And it really is just a compact flash card reader with a USB port on it. And the micro drive, it's a Magic Store 2.2 gigabyte, so that's why it's larger than 2 gigabytes. And it is an IDE drive. I know some of these micro drives that were used in things like MP3 players had a custom firmware which prevented you from using them as a standard IDE drive. But this one says right on it, ATA/IDE, and there you can kind of see how it's a tiny little hard drive in the space of a compact flash card. So here's the comparison to the solid state compact flash card. The same form factor, it's just a little bit thicker. I think these micro drives are great for vintage computers because you can use them with any inexpensive compact flash to IDE adapter, either this one for converting it to a 3.5-inch IDE interface for a desktop PC, or one of these for a 2.5-inch drive for a laptop. And it fits and works just fine, just like a compact flash card would. Except it's a real mechanical spinning hard drive. So in case you just don't feel right putting a solid state flash memory drive in a vintage computer, you can use one of these, and it'll be a lot faster and smaller and quieter and use less power than an old fashioned mechanical hard drive, but it's still a hard drive, just in a much smaller form factor. And they made these micro drives in capacities up to 16 gigabytes, but even this one at 2.2 gigabytes is more than you would ever need on a computer like this, which is a 486. So even though these Quickie drives are pretty much useless these days for the originally intended purpose of being a portable USB hard drive, you can easily crack them open and take out the micro drive inside it, and then use it with your vintage computer. Or if you really wanted to, you could stick a compact flash card in the Quickie drive and just use it as a really ugly compact flash card reader.